Are you looking to pass your Security Plus exam the right way and in just 60 days? Are you struggling with Security Plus exam? Or find yourself stuck in a learning loop, consuming every training available out there in your quest for a fail-safe solution? So stick around and learn how you can do it too. And if you're wondering who is this guy who is advising me what to do or not to do, let me reassure you, I walk the walk. I have earned all the certifications that you can think of, like CCNA, CCNP, NSE7, the whole lot of them. And if you're new here, my name is Sohail. I'm a cybersecurity consultant based in Australia, and I help IT professionals just like you in transitioning into cybersecurity the right way. Now, without further ado, let's dive into the topic. In this video, I won't be debating whether you need Security Plus certification or not. Instead, I'll be outlining the exact steps that you need to take in order to pass your Security Plus exam as fast as possible. The first step is honesty and commitment. Remember why you have embarked on this journey and remind yourself to dedicate at least 1 or 2 hours per day. Promise yourself that you will allocate 1 or 2 hours per day for studies. Believe me, 1 or 2 hours isn't that long. You can easily allocate this time early in the morning or in the evening after work. I recommend using time blocking technique in your calendar and book 1 or 2 hours per day in advance in your Google Calendar, for instance. Make sure nothing disturbs you during this time. Inform your family or your partner about your study time. Protect those hours at all costs. And don't try to spend more than 2 hours for your studies. Remember, at the end of the day, consistency is the key. The second step involves video training. Whether it's free or on a platform like Udemy, videos can give you a feel for the topics. Say you're watching Professor Messer's or Diane's Security Plus training. The whole course might be around 21 hours or so. If you allocate 2 hours per day, you should be able to finish that whole course in just 2 weeks. Note taking is crucial here. Your initial viewing should familiarize you with the topics and the structure of Security Plus. It's all about kickstarting the learning machine in your mind. The third step comes after the video training, where many people make mistakes. They start seeking more resources, reading books from the start to end, which only adds more pressure and extends the process. Here, the only thing you need to do is practice tests. Nothing more, nothing less. Security Plus certification, at the end of the day, is just a ticket to pass the screening process. Don't overthink it. Most of what you learn in Security Plus won't directly apply to the real world. Your task in this step is to take as many practice tests as you can. The first round might be rough, but that's completely normal. Jot down the topics that you're struggling with, then refer back to the video training or your notes. This is a cycle of repetition, review, test, review, test, until you can confidently answer 80% of the questions. Another tip, once you start your practice test preparation, book the exam in advance. This creates a sense of urgency and pushes you to prepare better. Treat the exam date as immovable. No rescheduling allowed. During the exam, many people make the mistakes of spending too much time on a single question. This is something that you should avoid at all costs. Never allocate more than a minute on a single question. If you're having trouble with a particular question, just flag it. You'll be able to revisit those questions at the end of the exam. Spending too much time on a single question can lead to stress and waste valuable time that could have been spent on other questions. Remember to keep moving forward and keep your momentum going. At the end of the day, remember that it's just an exam. You must ensure that you're consistent in your preparation, but also take care not to burn yourself out. If you're studying every day, make sure to give yourself a break over the weekend. Let's say Sunday. Spend this day outdoors with your family or doing activities that help you relax and not to think about the exam. This is the best time to recharge for the coming week. Consistent daily preparation and studying without a break can lead to a burnout and a stress. We don't want that to happen to you. Always remind yourself about the bigger picture here. This exam is a stepping stone toward your career goals. A calm, healthy mind can perform better than a tired one. So be kind to yourself, take regular breaks, and remember to reward yourself for your progress. It's not just about passing the exam. It's about learning and growing in the field of cybersecurity. You've got this. Remember, consistency is the key. If you follow the exact step-by-step process that I have outlined in this video, I'll guarantee you you pass the exam in no time. I've done this myself and so can you. If you found this video useful, please like, subscribe, and leave a comment to help me with the YouTube algorithm so I can reach more people. Thank you so much for watching. See you later.